Ever since the mini foods fiasco,
skip a meal, fatty,
which truly was a fiasco, people have been bringing all sorts of mini foods to my attention, which is really sweet of you. Most of them, however, are just crap, so stop it, would you?
No! Get out of it!
But today I'll be making, on a suggestion, Poppin Cookin's... Whatever this is. The Poppin Cookin do-it-yourself candy sushi kit comes to you all the way from Japan. And a quick shout out to my two subscribers from Japan. This product, and many others like it, are sold overseas under the category of intellectual educational candy.
I'm sorry, what?
Yes, that's right. It's a healthy candy using only natural colorings, which children have to mix together and make themselves, allowing them to, quote, develop and be creative. Because nothing says health and education like giving your kids every kind of diabetes. Upon opening this little box of craziness, we're presented with a mixing tray, a shovel, an eyedropper, and a bunch of sachets of various chemicals. I mean solutions. Apparently these promote health because they use natural colorings like the red dye from cabbage and squid ink. On top of that, you can also expect to get yourself a healthy dose of calcium carbonate, sorbitol, calcium sulfate, glycerin, sodium pyrophosphate. And yes, while many of these are just common, harmless food additives, I just don't want my food to have more compounds and chemicals in it than a chemistry exam. Now, because I can't read a single word off the back of a box,
it's like trying to make something from IKEA,
I found some English instructions online. First thing we need to do is make the rice. So we put some water in here and add a giant packet of blue.
Oh, it's such a fine powder.
Don't breathe it in. It's on my lungs.
So just mix that through.
And somehow that forms a ball of candy that has a consistency very much like rice. No one else is concerned by that at all. We then mix mystery yellow sachet with water in this tray and pinkish reddish sachet with water in this tray and wait for them to set. I mixed them in the wrong trays. Whilst that's happening, I can mold the seaweed into shape from this little block of Play-Doh? Well, it's probably gum or something, right?
I probably took this a bit too far, didn't I? Fit this into that shape.
We can then make the salmon roe by taking random orange stuff and dropping it into mystery blue liquid. This causes the liquid to form small salmon roe-like balls because science.
And we'll drain those off.
The last concoction we'll make is by mixing this dark powder with some water. Now it's time to assemble our sushi. Shape the rice, wrap around some seaweed, throw on a bit of egg stuff, a bit of salmon, salmon roe on top, and there it is. A smorgasbord of intellectual, educational candy sushi designed to promote health, development, and creativity. But now for the taste test. I'm going to start with the egg thing. Turns out that last liquid we created was a candy type soy sauce.
Bit of soy. Oh. Oh no. Oh. It's grape. The whole thing is grape. Everything is grape flavored. The rice has a consistency of snot, grape flavored snot.
That was not pleasant.
I do not want to eat the other ones.
So the salmon!
Not surprisingly, tastes like grape. It's just mush. Okay. Even the soy is grape. And this last little number tastes...
Yep.
Just as shit.
What is the black stuff?
That was a whole bag crazy. Everything tasted artificial, like plastic.
I know less now than I did before, and I kind of feel like I've taken 3 years off my life. Thanks to the subscriber who sent that suggestion in, and if you've got ideas you think would make a great video, why don't you keep them to yourself?
I need large amounts of water. Why didn't I put the skirt on?
Follow the Andrew Wood Fiasco on Facebook and Twitter, or just don't.